Chemda, strictly speaking, is not a school at all. Imagine the following situation. Imagine that you have, let's say, 20 high schools, 20 gymnasiums, and each one of them has a physics lab or a physics room, which is the kingdom of the physics teacher, and maybe next to it a preparation room where all the equipment are, and in a lucky school there is even a technician who can prepare the experiments. So there are 20 such schools and there are 20 such rooms. Imagine that an angel came and took the 20 rooms of the 20 schools and moved them into one school. Imagine that the same angel combined all the preparation rooms into one large room with all the equipment, that the same equipment is used by the 20 schools. Sometimes there's a piece of equipment which is very expensive and you need to use it once a year. It would be absolutely outrageous for a school, even if they had the money, to buy an enormously expensive piece of equipment that they use once a year. But if you buy one such piece of equipment for the entire city of Tel Aviv, it's a different story. So what we have done is we did not build a school. We built a building which contains, so to speak, the physics labs, the physics rooms, and the physics preparation rooms of all the schools in Tel Aviv in one building. And theoretically speaking, if the child comes to the school in the morning and from 8 to 9 they study English and from 9 to 10 they study physics, theoretically speaking, the physics between 9 and 10 will have to be in our building of Chemda rather than in the school. Now, of course, in practice, you cannot move from a faraway school to Chemda in 10 minutes of the intermission. So what we do is they come to Chemda twice a week for 3 or 4 hours at a time. That's where they do all their physics study. The rest of the year, the rest of the week or the rest of the year, they're studying in their own school all the other subjects. And when the school, every school in its own location, is having, let's say, a meeting of the teachers to discuss the class or the programs or the children, the physics teacher from Chemda goes to the school and participate as if he or she are one of the teachers of the school. So the teaching of Chemda is like 20 different branches of 20 different schools, all in one location, saving the money, saving the resources, and providing a whole new way of teaching physics. And this has been working really like a charm, plus additional programs that we added on various other subjects. We have a double theme. One is to be normal, conventional, square, prepare for the matriculation. Every class has a teacher. The teacher teaches that particular class. The children know that this is my teacher. And that is a square part of Chemda. Then there is the unconventional part. The teacher who get to know the children from the other classes. The teacher who invites another teacher to co-teach a certain subject. The teacher who is trying to perform an experiment in the class and he knows that another teacher is doing this experiment in a wonderful way and he himself, the original teacher, is having difficulties, so he asks him to help. So these are all informal things out of the box. They happen sometimes frequently, sometimes rarely. There are also a lot of other activities. For instance, there are afternoon small classes for children who ask for it. So there are no private lessons with a private tutor elsewhere for the children that go to Chemda. If a child has difficulties in a certain subject, he or she can attend such classes, given sometimes by the same teacher of the class, sometimes by another teacher, sometimes with children from another class, etc. Another informal situation, there are schools in usually in poorer neighborhoods which never offered a high-level physics program because there were only 5 kids in the school who wanted to take high-level physics. And Chemda can offer it because Chemda can take 4 different schools which has 5 kids each that want to study physics, and create one class of 20 children, which is then catering to them. So thanks to Hemda, the teaching of high-level physics, which leads to a high-level matriculation exam, has penetrated also areas of Tel Aviv in which this did not exist before. All of these are the unconventional benefits, and they are not really programmed in a logical, computerized way. They just happened. But things like that always happen when many good people are thinking together.